tiempo. Passion.
These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. Chief Deputy Commissioner is Nick Santoro. Timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mittman. The attending physician is Dr. John Woods. Referees for this hour are Dick Worley, Mario Civoldi, John Stanley, and Gilberto Roman. And I'm your ring announcer for All-Star Wrestling, Gary Capetta. The first match in the ring is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Brooklyn, New York, weighing 239 pounds, the unpredictable Johnny Rodz. And his opponent, 267 pounds, the great Hossein Arab of Iran.
So there we have the principles, and what should prove to be quite an interesting match. Rod's an aggressor, perhaps not quite as much as the great Hossein, but it's going to make for a most exciting match. Here we go. Hossein having his problems at the moment. What do you look for in this match, Bruno?
Well, see, two very aggressive men here. I think it should be a pretty tough bout for both. I look for Hossein with the superiority as far as the wrestling abilities to overcome Rodz, but he should have his hands full because Rodz is such an aggressive competitor. It should be a pretty tough bout.
Well, Hossein, for some reason, is kind of taking exception to the latest turn of events. Do you think he has underestimated the skills of Johnny Rodz?
I don't know. I'll tell you, to me, they both seem a little more cautious than we ordinarily see them. Usually we see both of these individuals, type they will go after an opponent immediately. Since they come in, they seem like they're very cautious, more cautious with one another, testing each other out. When they do lock horns, they do move aggressively towards one another. But when they separate, they seem very cautious before they make their next move. I think that one has respect for the other. And like I say, it's going to be interesting to see the outcome of this. But I do feel that Hossein, with his superior wrestling skills and maneuvers, such as the suplex, he should be able to overcome Johnny Rodz.
Well, Hossein. Oh, there's Fred Plassey. Time for a little consultation, apparently. Oh, there goes Johnny Rodz after Fred Plassey. Better watch his back. I'm sure Johnny Rodz is taking exception to the presence of Fred Plassey. Rodz is doing all right for himself earlier in the match, but perhaps feels that with the presence of Fred Plassey, he's not likely to do quite as well.
Well, I don't know. You know, the man has to have ability, which he does have, and I don't know. Oh, did you see that, Vince?
Yes, indeed. And look at the latest turnaround. Johnny Rodz trying to slip out, sit out on him. Rodz hooks a leg, takes him up. Almost over. On out, yes. Hossein on the outside, and Plassey does not like the latest turn of events. Back to the apron now, Johnny Rodz, better watch it from behind. Now, great Hossein attacking.
Oh,
Johnny Rods now, whipped to the ropes, headed off the Saint, waiting for it. Back body drop. Off again, sunset flip, he'll have it. No, he won't. Very few individuals can escape a hold such as that, Bruno, when the momentum is going the opposite direction. Hussein is one of them.
Well, John Cerny's been on the receiving end, though. Hussein has taken charge for a while now, and he's been on him. And, oh, here he comes, flying in the air right on Rods' back.
Rods kind of slumping across that rope. And you can just imagine the impact as Hussein let him have it. Hussein now, off again, coming right back. Johnny Rods moving out of the way. Johnny Rods pouring it on. All right, in, rocking it, drop kick by Rods. Johnny Rods feeling the momentum. A regular face by Hussein. Rods now whipped to the rope, headed off. Hussein waiting for him. A headbutt clearly in the abdominal area. Rods whipped into the foot gear. Uh-oh. Rods suplexed by Hussein. Hussein right on top of his man. And it's over. So Hussein knows full well he's been in a match here with Johnny Rods. But in the end, it's Iran's great Hussein.
The time of the match, 5 minutes, 51 seconds, and your winner, the great Hussein Arab of Iran.
The great Hussein, victorious. Bruno, let's go back and take a closer look at the suplex.
Yeah, here he goes. He picks him up after he had already given him that loaded boot. He took Rods with the greatest of ease in this particular suplex here. And, of course, that knocked all the wind right out of Johnny Rods.
When you're in the air like this now, you're Johnny Rods, you're scooped upside down. The equilibrium has to be totally whacked out. And then from there, the impact, not just the fall itself, which can unquestionably injure a man and knock him out, but in addition to that, you can see, look at the position Hussein is. Look at his legs. He's driving Johnny Rods down to the canvas. Rods isn't falling. He's driving him down.
Exactly. He's driving him down with all his weight on there, and with the impact is tremendous.